Hello students, this is Anthony Christie Melson, Department of Mathematics, BMS College of Engineering. In this lecture, we will be discussing about the minimal polynomial of a matrix. In the previous lecture, we had discussed about finding eigenspaces of a matrix. Now, given the characteristic polynomial, in this lecture, we'll see how we can find a minimal polynomial of a matrix. To begin with, we will define a few concepts. A monic polynomial. We have f of t as a naught t power n plus a1 t power n minus 1 plus a2 t power n minus 2 plus a n. If a naught equal to 1, then f of t is called a monic polynomial. A minimal polynomial. A square matrix A. Now we have A to be a square matrix. A set J of A defined as F of T, which belongs to the set of all polynomials of degree of less than or equal to n. Say we take square matrix of order n. Now J of A is the set of all polynomials such that f of a equal to 0. J of a is not a null set because the characteristic polynomial belongs to J of A. So least degree polynomial, the least degree monic polynomial in J of A. Is called the minimal polynomial of A. The minimal polynomial say M of T it should contain the minimal polynomial M of T should contain all irreducible factors of the characteristic polynomial. M of T
should divide the characteristic polynomial delta of t. Now, determinant A minus lambda I is minus 1 power n lambda power n plus minus 1 power n minus 1 trace of A lambda power n minus 1 and so on. So, delta of t is t power n minus trace of A t power n minus 1 plus and so on. Here, a determinant A minus lambda I, the polynomial in lambda is multiplied throughout with minus 1 power n and lambda is replaced by t. We will find the minimal polynomial for a matrix. As an example, consider the matrix A equal to 2, 2, minus 5, 3, 7, minus 15, 1, 2, minus 4. To find the minimal polynomial, the first step is to find a characteristic polynomial. So we have A minus lambda I, the determinant equal to minus lambda cube plus trace of A lambda squared minus sum of the principal minus into lambda plus determinant A. So this will be minus lambda cube plus 2 plus 7, 9 minus 4, that is 5 lambda squared minus m11 will be 2 plus m22 will be minus 3, m33 will be into lambda plus the determinant will be 3. So this is minus lambda cube plus 5 lambda squared minus 7 lambda plus 3, which simplifies to minus of lambda cube minus 5 lambda squared plus 7 lambda minus 3. So the characteristic polynomial delta of t will be t cube minus 5 t squared plus 7 t minus 3, which can be factorized as t minus 1 squared into t minus 3. Finding the eigenvalues will result in lambda equal to 1 and 3, with lambda equal to 1 the repeated root. Therefore, this should be minus lambda minus 1 squared into lambda minus 3, and from this we can write this characteristic polynomial. The minimal polynomial should have all the irreducible factors of the characteristic polynomial. Therefore, let f of t equal to t minus 1 into t minus 3. Now that we need to check if f of a equal to 0. If this is true, then m of t, that is the minimal polynomial, will be t minus 1 into t minus 3. Else, m of t will be delta of t. That is because we are sure that delta of A equal to 0 by Kelly-Hamilton theorem. Now f of A is A minus I into A minus 3i. If we recollect, the matrix polynomial f of A is obtained by replacing t with A and the constants with the constant times the identity matrix. Therefore, t minus 1 results in A minus I, t minus 3 results in A minus 3i. Now this will be, we have the matrix A here, so A minus I will be 1, 2, minus 5, 3, 7 minus 1 is 6, minus 15, 1, 2, minus 4, minus 1, that is minus 5, into A minus 3i will be minus 1, 2, minus 5. These elements will remain same. So the diagonal elements, 7 minus 3 is 4, minus 4 minus 3 is minus 7. One can easily verify that the f of A will reduce to 0, 0, 0. This will be a 0 matrix. This implies the minimal polynomial is t minus 1 into t minus 3. Let us take another example to understand finding the minimal polynomial. Consider the matrix 3 minus 2, 2, 4 minus 4, 6, 2 minus 3, 5. The characteristic polynomial is minus lambda cube plus the trace of the matrix, which is 4 into lambda squared, minus the sum of the minors, that will be minus 2 plus 11 minus 4 times lambda plus the determinant, which is 2. This simplifies to minus lambda cube minus 4 lambda squared plus 5 lambda minus 2, which is minus lambda minus 1 whole squared into lambda minus 2. Therefore, the characteristic polynomial delta of t will be t minus 1 squared into t minus 2. So we construct the polynomial f of t, which contains all the irreducible factors of delta of t, that is t minus 1 and t minus 2. Now we need to verify whether f of a equal to 0 or not. F of a is a minus I into a minus 2i. So this will be a minus I will be, the non-diagonal elements will remain as it is. So the diagonal elements will be 3 minus 1, that is 2, minus 4 minus 1, that is minus 5, 5 minus 1, that is 4. Similarly, we have minus 2, 2, 4, 6, 2 and minus 3 as the non-diagonal elements. So a minus 2i will result in 3 minus 2, minus 4 minus 2, that is minus 6, 5 minus 2, that is 3 along the principal diagonal. So we find this to be minus 2 as the first element. Doesn't matter about what the other elements are, and this is not a zero matrix. Therefore, f of t can't be a minimal polynomial. Therefore, the characteristic polynomial itself turns out to be the minimal polynomial for this particular problem. Next, we define the block matrices. If I have a matrix, say 1, 2, three, four, five, one, one, two, two, three, one, two, one, two, one, three, zero, one, three, five. Now this matrix can be partitioned into number of submatrices using a series of horizontal and vertical lines. Now, one partition would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 3, 0, 1, 3, 5. Where we have square submatrices, two square submatrices in the first row and the second row. So this is equivalent to A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, where these AIJs are all the submatrices of matrix A. Now the same matrix can be partitioned in another way. So in this case, we have A11 dash, A12 dash, A21 dash, A22 dash, and so on. Depending on how the matrix is partitioned, we can have different submatrices. A matrix M is said to be a square block matrix M if M is a square matrix. The blocks of M form a square matrix. Diagonal blocks R square. As a special case, our diagonal block matrix would be a square block matrix. Non-zero diagonal blocks at least some non-zero diagonal blocks, and the remaining non-zero diagonal blocks as zero blocks. Similarly, we can define lower triangular block matrices. Here we have at least some non-zero blocks in the lower triangle, and the upper triangle consists of the zeros, and the upper triangular the block matrices, where the lower triangle consists of zero blocks and the upper triangle at least some of them are non-zero blocks. The properties of diagonal block matrices are, if M is a diagonal block, matrix, then with M equal to diag of M11, M22, MNN, then F of M, that is the polynomial of M, the matrix M would be diagonal of F of M11, F of M22, to F of MNN, and the characteristic polynomial of M will be delta 1 of T into delta 2 of T, delta 3 of T up to delta N of T, where delta I's are the characteristic polynomial of each of the diagonal blocks, and the minimal polynomial in this case will be the LCM of M1 of T, M2 of T, MN of T, where M1, M2, M3 and so on are the minimal polynomials of the diagonal blocks M11, M22 up to MNN. Now these two properties holds good for lower triangle and upper triangle block matrices. Now consider the matrix A with 2, 5 and 5 in the first row, the remaining 0, 0, 2, 000, 00, 420, 00, 350, 0, 0, 0, 0, 7. Now this matrix can be partitioned as follows. Now this partition gives us three diagonal blocks, that is A1 equal to 2502, A2 equal to 4235, and A3 equal to 7. So matrix A is diag of A1, A2, A3. As described earlier, to find the characteristic polynomial of A, we need to find the characteristic polynomial of A1, A2 and A3. The characteristic polynomial of A1 is given by A minus lambda I, that will be lambda squared minus 4 lambda plus 4, which is lambda minus 2 whole squared, So delta 1 of t will be t minus 2 whole squared. Now if we choose f of t as t minus 2, f of a, that is f of a1, that is a1 minus 2i, definitely not equal to 0, because a1 is not an identity matrix or a diagonal matrix with diagonal elements 2. Therefore, this cannot be a minimal polynomial of a1. And so m1 of t will be the same as t minus 2 whole squared. Similarly, a2 minus lambda equal to 0 results in lambda squared minus 9 lambda plus 14, which results in lambda minus 2 into lambda minus 7. So the characteristic polynomial of the block A2 will be t minus 2 into t minus 7. And we find here that t minus 2 into t minus 7 is the only irreducible factor, and no other polynomial with 2 and 7 as the roots is possible. Therefore, minimal polynomial for A2 will be t minus 2 into t minus 7. Bingo. We have A3 equal to 7. This implies the characteristic polynomial for this block will be t minus 7, which is also the minimal polynomial in this case. So we have delta 1 of t to be t minus 2 squared, and a minimal polynomial of a1 as t minus 2 squared. Delta 2 of t, that is the characteristic polynomial of a2 as t minus 2 into t minus 7, and minimal polynomial as t minus 2 into t minus 7. And we have delta 3 and so the characteristic polynomial of matrix A, this is delta 1, delta 2, delta 3. Therefore, we have t minus 2 cube into t minus 7 squared. Now, minimal polynomial of the matrix A is the LCM, that is the least common multiple of m1 of t, m2 of t, m3 of t, that is the least common multiple of t minus 2 squared, t minus 2 into t minus 7, and t minus 7. So when we are choosing the least common multiple of a polynomial for polynomials, we need to consider the highest degree polynomial of a particular factor along with the unique factors. So the for t minus 2, the highest degree factor would be 2. So we have t minus 2 squared into t minus 7 being a unique factor here. So we consider t minus 7. So this will be the minimal polynomial of the matrix A. So we have characteristic polynomial given by this and the minimal polynomial here. One can easily verify that m of A will be equal to a minus 2i squared into a minus 7i will be a zero matrix. We will consider another example. In this example, we have a square matrix of 4 cross 4, and if we partition the matrix in this form, we see that this is a upper triangular block matrix. We have A1, A11 to B, 1 minus 1, 1, 3, and A22 as 6, 5, 2, 3. To find the characteristic polynomial of and minimal polynomial of A, we only require to find the characteristic polynomial of A11 and A22 and the minimal polynomial of A11 and A22, which we'll call them as delta 1 and delta 2 for the characteristic polynomial, M1 and M2 for the minimal polynomial. The characteristic polynomial of A11 will be, find the characteristic polynomial of A11, we consider a determinant of A11 minus lambda I, which is lambda squared minus 4 lambda plus 4, which is lambda minus 2 whole squared. So the characteristic polynomial delta 1 of T will be T squared, or T minus 2 whole squared. Similarly, now it's very obvious that A11 minus 2i not equal to 0. This implies T minus 2 cannot be the minimal polynomial of A11. Therefore, M1 of T will be T minus 2 whole squared. Similarly, A22 minus lambda I, which is lambda squared minus 9 lambda plus 8, which is lambda minus 1 . Therefore, we have characteristic polynomial of A22 to be T minus 1 into T minus 8. Again, we see that A22 minus, now the only irreducible factors here are T minus 1 and T minus 8. Therefore, we see delta 2 of T is the same as the minimal polynomial of A22, as there are no other irreducible factors other than T minus 1 and T minus 8. The characteristic polynomial of matrix A is the product of the characteristic polynomials of the diagonal blocks. Therefore, we have T minus 2 squared into T minus 1 into T minus 8 as the characteristic polynomial. The minimal polynomial will be the LCM of M1 of T and M2 of T, which is the LCM of T minus 2 squared, T minus 1, T minus 8. We find that there is no common multiple here or common factors, and therefore the LCM of this would be the product of the two, that is T minus 2 squared into T minus 1 into t minus 8. So here we have the characteristic polynomial, and this would be the minimal polynomial.